Shepard, how can I help?
Let's talk.
You got a minute to talk?
Yes, good timing, in fact. Excellent. Made breakthrough. Can share results while next samples grow.
Ooh.
Hate waiting for culture analysis. Never fast enough. Usually no result in advance. Just checking work. Have to be careful.
Well, you always gotta check your work, man.
Discovery. Based on Prothean collector connection, can examine technology, chart Reaper species modification, fall of Protheans.
Interesting.
Tell me what happened.
Early stages similar to indoctrination. Can guess captured Protheans lost intelligence over several cloned generations. Cybernetic augmentation widespread afterward. As Protheans failed, Reapers added tech to compensate. Mental capacity almost gone, replaced by overworked sensory input transfers. Transmitting data to masters.
Can they be saved, I guess?
Is there anything we can do to help them?
No. No glands replaced by tech. No digestive system replaced by tech. No soul replaced by tech. Whatever they were, gone forever. Understand now? No art, no culture, closer to husks than slaves, tools for Reapers. Protheans dead, collectors just final insult. Must be destroyed.
Tell me about your interest in art.
You said the collectors had no art. I had no idea you cared about that kind of thing.
Personal interest negligible. Sang a little, multi-species productions for cultural exploration. Gilbert and Sullivan always had me do the patter songs. But not about me. Cultural artistic expression reflects philosophical evolution.
That's great.
Interest in growth.
The idea of Morton participating in a musical is just tickles me to no end.
Culturally dead. Tools for Reapers. Worse than the Geth.
You sang?
I'm sorry. I know that was important, but you performed Gilbert and Sullivan?
I am the very model of a scientist Salarian. I've studied species Turian, Asari, and Batarian.
Oh my god!
I'm good at genetics as a subset of biology because I am an expert which I know as a tautology. My xenoscience studies range from urban to agrarian. I am the very model of a scientist Salarian.
That's amazing! That...
I can tell by
that facial expression does not reflect mine at all in this instance.
Your eyes are as big as dinner plates.
Oh my god, that's hilarious.
Oh, that is probably one of the best Morden moments ever.
Oh my god, that's amazing. Oh.
What is it about the collector's modifications that bothers you so much?
Disrupts socio-technological balance. All scientific advancement due to intelligence overcoming, compensating for limitations. Can't carry a load, so invent wheel. Can't catch food, so invent spear. Limitations. No limitations, no advancement. No advancement, culture stagnates. Works other way, too. Advancement before culture is ready. Disastrous. Saw it with Krogan. Uplifted by Salarians. Disastrous. Our fault.
I'm sorry, I can't get over the singing.
If you feel that way, why did you work on the genophage modification?
Talked before. Best option. That or kill them all. If around during first contact, would have argued against it. Wasn't there then. Do what I can.
What's this about your fault? Question mark. Let's see.
You blame the Salarians for what the Krogan did?
Yes. Like giving nuclear weapons to cavemen. Krogan unprepared for spaceflight, technological advance. Krogan could have evolved alone, worked out aggression, been ready to use new tech responsibly. Instead, Salarians came, disrupted Krogan culture, used Krogan as blunt instrument against Rachni.
Oh, there we go. He's back. Morton, you're off frame. You're off frame. Stage right. Stage right, Morton. Okay, there you go.
Well, that's how Morton feels about the Krogan being uplifted beyond they were ready.
Morton's off frame again.
He's on a shot! Yeah, they probably shouldn't have given spaceflight technology to the Krogan so early.
Yeah, that might have been a mistake.
Yeah. It's good talking to you. I don't think I... Oh, what's your motivation?
I didn't think you needed any more motivation than you already had to stop the collectors.
Enjoyed challenge. Saw necessity of attack on collectors after plague on Omega. Their work, my people. Hard to care about two armies. One wins, one loses. Always work to do after. Now, have more context. See what collectors are. Wasn't looking for other work before. Don't mean to imply that. Just committed now. Won't let you down.
All right. Thanks, Morton. I'll talk to you later.
Thanks for sharing what you've learned, Morton.
Proud to be here, Shepard. Thank you for including me.
You're welcome. I like you, Morton.
I think everyone loves Morton.
Hey, Shepard.
Howdy.
Jacob deserves better than a father like that. I probably would have wanted to shoot him too.
We left him there to be devoured by the locals.
Yeah, a much nicer fate.
Yes.
I'm glad to hear Thane and his son are back in touch. It'll be hard, but I think they'll be fine.
That's good.
I'm really glad you got Tally out of trouble with the migrant fleet. It's hard to see her upset.
Yeah, I know, that's why I did it! It's so hard!
Shepard, need me for something?
What do you have to say? Or are you doing calibrations?
Have you got a minute?
Sure, just killing time anyway.
Oh, okay, cool.
I wanted to thank you again for your help with Sidonis. Whatever happens with the Collectors or the Reapers or whoever else comes after us, I know you'll get the job done.
Yeah, I'm glad you're here.
I couldn't do this without you, Garrus.
Sure you could. Not as stylishly, of course. It's strange going into a suicide mission on a human ship. Your people don't prepare for high-risk operations the way Turians do.
What do you mean by that? What do they do?
How do Turian crews get ready for high-risk missions?
With violence, usually. Turian ships have more operational discipline than your Alliance, but fewer personal restrictions. Our commanders run us tight, and they know we need to blow off steam. Turian ships have training rooms for exercise, combat sims, even full-contact sparring. Whatever lets people work off stress.
Full-contact sparring. That sounds interesting and painful.
You mean Turian ships have crewmen fighting each other before a mission?
It's supervised, of course. Nobody's going to risk an injury that interferes with the mission, and it's a good way to settle grudges amicably. I remember right before one mission, we were about to hit a Batarian pirate squad. Very risky. This recon scout and I had been at each other's throats. Nerves, mostly. She suggested we settle it in the ring.
And how'd that go? Get your ass beat?
I assume you took her down gently?
Actually, she and I were the top-ranked hand-to-hand specialists on the ship. I had reach, but she had flexibility. It was brutal. After 9 rounds, the judge called it a draw. There were a lot of unhappy bettors in the training room. We ended up holding a tiebreaker in her quarters. I had reach, but she had flexibility.
Oh, Garrus.
You sly dog.
Oh, my. What about Ilios?
I thought you'd be used to high-risk operations on human ships. I mean, think about tracking Sarah to Ilos.
Sure, but that was quick. We raced out, landed, blew up some Geth, and saved the galaxy. This time we've got Miranda and Cerberus and that AI all telling us what we're up against. I think I preferred blind optimism.
What's your estimation of our chances?
Honestly, Garrus, what do you think our chances are?
Honestly? The Collectors killed you once, and all they did is piss you off. I can't imagine they'll stop you this time. But an unmapped area, advanced technology, and the Collectors. We're going to lose people. No way around that.
Well, hopefully
not
just
a
Jacob.
Happy announcement. Spread it around, and I'm with you regardless.
Oh, that was mean. So what about you and C-Sec? How'd that go?
Do you ever regret leaving C-Sec or the Turian military?
Not for a minute. When it comes down to it, Shepard, I don't think I'm a very good Turian. When a good Turian hears a bad order, he follows it. He might complain, but he knows his place. I just don't see the point in staying quiet and polite. Not when the galaxy is at stake.
That's why we got you with us, Garrus.
Yeah, that's why we got you with us, and that's why I'm trying to get Miranda to come over here, but she's being kind of whiny lately. Garrus, I'm gonna send Miranda in here in like 10 minutes. We're gonna do some... I'm gonna have you guys do some full contact sparring.
Yeah, just so you know, she has flexibility.
Miranda, what news have you? Also, how come your bed is bigger than mine? Follow up. God, are these sheets like 900 thread count? Oh my god, those are smooth.
I'm gonna have a talk with the elusive man later. I need sheets like that.
I need sheets like that. Miranda, you're like the requisitions officer, right? Go get some sheets for me.
Give me your sheets.
Give me your bed. No, I'm not gonna take your bed sheets, but get me new ones. Because that's mean. I'm not taking your bed sheets.
Miranda, sleep outside of the ship.
Yeah, sleep outside of the ship. Also, go talk to Garrus right now.
Commander, what can I do for you?
You have a minute, Miranda?
Of course. I've been meaning to speak with you, in fact.
I hear you like sheets.
Uh-oh.
I wanted to apologize. I didn't fully believe you'd be up to the task, and it seems I was wrong.
Uh-oh.
Frankly, based on what I've seen, I wish Cerberus had recruited you earlier.
Uh-oh.
No, this isn't about a romantic encounter.
I don't like where this is going!
She's just apologizing about being a dick to you. That's all.
Cerberus is wrong!
She might not agree with that, but you could state your opinion on that.
Why do you like Cerberus?
With your intelligence, you could have landed any job you wanted. Why choose this?
Because I still envy the time Morden spent with the Special Tasks Group, working with people as smart as he was. Cerberus never tells me that something is impossible. They give me my resources and say do it. And they've given you even more. A new life, a new ship, the elusive man's personal attention.
I'm not doing that one. I know what'll happen if I do that.
He also blessed me with your presence, Miranda. No? You're not gonna go with that option? No? Okay.
No! Tali!
You're violently shaking your head.
Oh, Tali!
Seriously, your neck's gonna break if you keep shaking it like that.
It's all about Tali.
What? You disapprove?
No. I'm just impressed. You're... Well, look at you. A colony kid growing up in a prefab unit. Losing even that when the Batarian slavers arrived. And you've done more than I could. Despite everything my father did to make me perfect, you're the best humanity has to offer.
I should be going.
But she needs a little bit of reassurance from you. She's feeling a little self-doubt.
This again.
Does it always have to come back to your father's genetic tailoring?
This is what I am, Shepard. I can't hide it. The intelligence, the looks, even the biotics. He paid for all of that. Every one of your accomplishments is due to your skill. The only things I can take credit for are my mistakes.
You're kind of hard to compliment, you know?
I can't admire your body or your mind.
No, that's not what I meant!
You give your father too much credit. Yeah, he gave you gifts. But you can be proud of what you've done with them.
Oh. Thank you. Perhaps I wouldn't mind if you admired my body.
Oh, no! No, 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 no! No, Tali! How does this keep happening? No, we can't do this!
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it that way. We need to stay professional. Keep our focus.
Yes, you're right. This is too important for anything to cause friction. Thank you for coming by, Commander.
The hell was that?
She turned off her flashlight. Zoop!
I gotta get out of here. I gotta get out. Now, maybe a different Captain Shepard would be in love with Miranda, but not this one. This one's all about Tali. Next Captain Shepard will go for Miranda.
God, I never get tired of you watching you accidentally romance somebody.
It's too easy! It's too easy. Terrence Shepard is just so charming. All the women want to read his Sonic fanfiction.
They are captivating.
The new armor reinforcements really threw off the gravimetric profiles. But engines are good to go. I rebalanced the Gilborne coefficients and adjusted the anterior intakes on the second tier stabilizers.
I love it when you talk dirty.
What intakes? We're in space! There's nothing to intake!
You're still injecting fuel somewhere or something.
Oh, maybe that's what he was talking about. Tali!
Shepard, what can I do for
you? I want to talk about you and pretend that I wasn't just up there talking to Miranda.
Have you got time to talk?
Sure. Let me just... Come on, you little bosh-tet! Oh, sorry. I've got a small fever and I'm taking it out on the poor drive core.
Oh.
Don't worry, it's nothing serious. Got sloppy while doing some suit repair.
How sick are you?
You're sick? Do you need help or time to rest?
Really, it's not that bad. If a stray bit of bacteria could really kill us, we'd have all died by now. The fever should go away in a day or two. Don't worry, it won't affect my performance on the mission. It's not even an illness, really. What we experience is actually an acute allergic reaction.
Oh man, I know things about acute allergic reactions. Wow, I have such bad allergies. Tali, do you ever get those like really bad like sinus headaches where it's like behind your nose and like right under both of your eyeballs? And it's just like so excruciatingly painful that like you have to keep one of your eyes closed at pretty much all times. Because if you open both of them, there's just way too much light and everything hurts.
Quarians don't have noses.
Yes, she does. I can see it in her mask.
Oh, I guess I can't pull one over on you, Commander.
How exactly does the sickness work? It's an allergic reaction?
Right. Say I get exposed to a human disease. Like, what did Navigator Presley have that time? Chickenpox? I wouldn't get chickenpox, but I'd run a fever as my system reacted to the foreign presence. Depending on where it hits me, I could get other symptoms. Nausea, vomiting, everything you'd expect from being sick.
What about this specific illness? I need to know more.
How did you get sick this time?
I took some fire in a fight back on the Olorai. Nothing serious, but I needed to open my suit to check the wound. I disinfected properly, but one of the section seals had taken some damage, and foreign matter got out of the disinfected zone. It was a stupid mistake. You always check your seals before doing local treatment. Unless you forget. Then you get a damn fever.
Oh, dude, your suit got like little sections that it can seal off in like different areas?
That's what it sounds like.
You can seal off part of your suit?
Right. Like dropping emergency doors on a ship during a
holiday. Oh, that's so cool!
Stop an infection that gets into my bloodstream, but it prevents a surface infection from spreading.
That sounds awesome!
Unless you have no choice but to wear a suit like that for your entire life.
That sounds awesome!
It probably isn't for her.
Oh, that's so cool, though!
Were your immune system stronger before the Geth drove you from your homeworld?
Not as strong as those of most races, definitely. I'm not a biologist, but there's a theory about it. Because our planet lacked insect life,
what?
Symbiotic relationships with large animals to spread seeds or pollen. Most viruses on our world were partially beneficial, so our immune systems evolved to be weak. They were more likely to adapt to contamination than fight it.
Hold up for a second. Your planet has no bugs.
No bugs!
Okay, cancel all of this mission. We're going and retaking the quarry at homeworld. Because I want a vacation on a beach that doesn't have fucking bugs on it.
It's too bad the Geth control that planet now.
No, we're taking it back. This is stupid. I hate bugs. We're going there. Okay, Tali, we're taking over your planet again.
It's going to become human homeworld number two. Sorry, Quarians.
No, the Quarians can still have it. I just want a beach house. With no bugs. No, I don't want a beach house. I don't really like the beach that much. I want a house in the forest with no bugs.
Maybe one day you can give Tali that dream world on the homeworld.
Maybe.
Build her a house in the homeworld, just like her father intended.
Just like her father. Well, no, it's my house. She's allowed to visit, though. She's allowed to also stay there.
And also live there.
And also live there. It's a co- we'll both own the house. We'll have a joint bank account.
I don't know if I could live inside a suit my whole life.
That's not true. I could.
We are in our suits even among family. The most intimate thing we can do with another Quarian is link our suit environments. We get sick at first, and then we adapt. It's our most important gesture of trust, of acceptance. I haven't trusted anyone enough for that, though. Except, well, no Quarians. You know what I mean.
Oh ho ho! Oh, I trust you too, Tali.
I appreciate the thought, Tali, and I feel the same way. But you don't have to prove anything to me.
I know. Well, not that I know, but I didn't mean it like that. It's it's really hot in here. It's just that the tradition also signifies a willingness for, intimacy. I wasn't trying to... It's not always like that. It's more... How did we even end up talking about this?
Oh, she's so cute when she's flustered. Are you making a pass at me, Tali?
Wait a minute. It sounds like you're suggesting something, Tali.
What could I possibly be suggesting? I mean, a young woman gets rescued by a dashing commander who lets her join his crew and then goes off to save the galaxy? How could she possibly develop any kind of interest in him?
Oh, finally! Finally, after two games, I am at the point that I wanted in the first game!
I can't wait for you to be rejected and see how you take that.
Oh my god, I will... Shepard will vent himself out the airlock. He will space himself a second time.
You have nothing to be embarrassed about, Tali. I feel the same way about you.
Really? I didn't know... You never... Well... Good. Anyway, I should get back to work. But thanks for coming by and talking.
Ooh, Tali is so awkward.
She's not the only one. You've got so much in common. You're both awkward and...
We're both awkward and easily flustered.
You both hate bugs and you both get allergies terribly.
We both get terrible allergies. I told you I would be a Quarian. I don't think Jack has anything new to say to me because I haven't done her frickin' mission yet.
I need to get to Pragya, Shepard. Soon.
Okay, well, let's do that right now.
I'll think about that. Meanwhile, I have to go.
Let's go do that right now.
And let's bring Tali on this mission.
Of course, why not?